And not only that, we need to understand this generational. So in order to get our praise to the next level, we got to share it with somebody. But then also I see David. David helps me understand, helps us understand this morning, verse number 5, that praise takes some time. Praise takes time. Praise is not going to happen overnight. Look at verse number 5. He says, I will meditate on the glorious splendor of your majesty and on your wondrous works. David said, in order, I will meditate. In order to meditate, I believe that you have to take up some time to meditate.
Amen.
Meditation means you have to think about it for a while.
Uh-huh.
It's not just close your eyes and all of a sudden it happens. You have to think about and meditate on some things. If I got some grillers in here, it's like marinating. Brother Smith, it's like you got to marinate the meat a little bit. You got to let it sit and allow that stuff to soak in.
Yes,
so the meat will taste a whole lot better when you put it on the grill. Well, if you meditate on the Word of God, it just takes time.
Yes, sir.
And a lot of times, that's where I get tripped up at.
Amen.
If I can be honest and transparent. Because sometimes, I don't know, maybe you don't do this, but maybe every now and then we want to meditate through the drive-thru. In our relationship with God, we want to meditate on the Word through the drive-thru. We don't want to sit down at the table anymore and wait for the food, wait for it to sink in, and wait for that Word of God to get deep down in our souls. Every now and then I want to drive through the drive-thru. Okay, I guess I'm by myself. I guess I'm all alone. Am I the only one that sat down at the table to meditate on the Word? And bam, all of a sudden I'm done and I think I received something? Don't happen that way. You got to meditate. It takes time. It takes a sacrifice in order to get to the next level. You have to block out some time. You have to be disciplined, just like David. Okay,
yes,
maybe.
Yes, sir.
I'm okay, by myself again. In athletics, they tell us that success doesn't happen overnight. The fact that you got to keep at it, you got to keep going to practice. And nowadays they have what's called two-a-days, and you have to spend time developing your gift. You have to spend time learning the playbook. And I imagine that the Brett Favres and the Randy Mosses, all these football players, they just don't get the playbook and everything automatically is success. They catch everything, they throw all the right passes, they know all the plays. That's not the case. They have to take some time to meditate on the playbook. So in order to get to the Super Bowl, they got to take some time to develop themselves before they can develop anybody else. So what am I saying? All I'm trying to say this morning is praise takes time. And you have to meditate on the Word of God. Not just believe. When you do that in your private time, when you come to corporate worship, you'll be shouting the roof off. Come on, somebody. You don't have time to fool around and worship if you meditate in private. When you step in the door, you'll come in dancing. You'll come and shout, no matter what song they're singing. Come on, somebody. We were in Bible study as we're talking about time and meditating. We was in Bible study this week, and we used the analogy of, do you remember when you used to go out? You remember? Come on, wake up. You remember? Sister Meeks, Brother Meeks, if y'all went out to party and to do your thing, do y'all remember what y'all did? You remember the process that you went through, the time that you took before you even got to the party? Somebody said they started when they got off work and they turned on the music up loud and they showered and ironed their clothes. This is time that you're taking because there was something you was looking forward to when you got dressed or you stopped at the barbershop, got your hair did and your nails done. You took some time out and you went by the bank, got a couple dollars. And if it was anything like me, you stopped at the store, got you something and put it on ice because you were thinking about what you was about to do. You were meditating. You was taking time to get yourself together. And by the time you picked up your boys and your girls when you got to the party, it didn't take the DJ to poke and pry you. You went stepped out and you stepped right on the dance floor and you had a good time. What are you trying to say, preacher? It comes that way to worship. If you spend time and meditate on who God is, I guarantee your prayer. So no matter what comes your way, in order for us, Pleasant Green, and get our praise to the next level, it takes time. Don't give up. Don't give up. David never gave up. No matter what David did, he never gave up. So David tells us this morning, we got to get our praise to the next level. It's got to be personal. It's got to be about him. Take your mind off. It's not about you. It's generational. You got to share it. And it takes time. Don't give up. And lastly, this is what I like about it. It's difficult because it helps me to get to the next level, because praise is not about us. It's not about us. So in order to get there, look at verses 6 through 8, just lastly, and we're done. It says 6, men shall speak the might of your awesome acts, and I will declare your greatness. They shall utter the memory of your greatness and shall sing of your righteousness. The Lord is gracious and full of anger, of compassion, slow to anger, and great in mercy. Everything David's talking about is about God. I don't see him talking about himself in those verses. I don't see him talking about it. It says everything that he'll do toward God, how he'll give praise to God. It was never about David taking any credit. Amen. David was humbling himself right now because David had some issues. He had some faults, and he recognized it was only by the grace of God he was where he was, or he did what he did. And so lastly, I just want to let you know that praise is not about us. I'm reminded everything that I see in the text this morning, it's all about God. It's all about him, what he did. And I like number 8. This is what I like. It says, the Lord is gracious and full of compassion. I don't know about you, but he is a gracious God. The fact that he blesses us despite ourselves, he blesses, his grace is unmerited favor. So that lets me know that it's really not about me, because I can't bless myself. Only God can bless you. God provides grace. It's not us. He's slow to anger. I don't know about this. This cuts me right now, because God, he's slow to anger. And I told you I'm not a perfect father. And I'm working on it, Sister Tima. But every now and then I'm fast to anger. Oh, come on, somebody. You snatched up your... I seen some of y'all snatching kids when they cut up and they didn't do nothing wrong. Every now and then we are quick to anger. But we ought to be more focused like God and be slow to anger. That lets me know that he's got patience with us. He keeps us. He says, you know what? I know you made some mistakes and you got some faults and you fell short. You got down. You stumbled. You looked at something you shouldn't have looked at, and you said you something you shouldn't have said. But he's slow to anger. Come on, somebody. The fact that he's full of compassion and full of mercy, because he's holding back. The God that we serve is holding back some things that we deserve even right now. Somebody's thinking about something they shouldn't be thinking about even right now in worship.
Yes, sir. All right.
And so we have to understand, David helps us understand this morning, that praise is not about us. And so in order to get to the next level, Pleasant Green, our praise to the next level, we have to understand that praise is not about us.